Oscar.
Hmm?
What's so terrific up in the sky that you're looking up there like that?
Well, you look up too, and in just a minute, you'll see for yourself. I hired Alphabet Bates to fly over and make one of my favorite letters.
Well, what letter is that?
Well, I'll give you a few hints.
Like what?
It's the first letter of terrific words like useless and ugly and upset.
Oh, I think I got the idea. Okay, let's watch. Look.
Ah, there he comes.
Oh, there he is. Look. See? See him?
Where is he?
Right up there. Wait, you see it? There, see?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. What's it gonna be?
Now, can you guess what letter he's gonna make?
A J.
Not an A. Not a J. Well, ding dong, you're all wrong.
Oh, no, no, it's gonna be O.
O. G.
That's it. I think you got it.
U.
What is that?
U.
Yeah.
Right, the letter U.
Oscar.
And it's also the first letter of great words like unhappy, unfriendly.
Oh, no. That's
unlucky.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Oh, yeah. Other words like unfair, uncooperative, uncouth, unhappy.
Unite. Unite.
This is a crane. It can be used as a shovel, like this. Wrecking ball like this.
Say, let's meet some more of the people in your neighborhood.
Oh, who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, in your neighborhood. Oh, who are the people in your neighborhood? The people that you meet each day.
Oh, here comes somebody now. Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Excuse me.
What?
I bet I can tell what you are.
What?
You're wearing a motorman's uniform.
Yes.
And you just came out of the subway entrance. That means you are a motorman, right?
Well, you're on the right track. Hey, do you know what a subway motorman does when he eats his lunch?
No, what?
Choo-choo.
why don't you just sing?
Oh, a motorman is always home. driving subway trains beneath the ground. So if you're traveling morning, noon, or night, well, I'll keep the subways running right. For a motorman's a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood. In your neighborhood. Yes, a motorman's a person in your neighborhood. A person that you meet each day.
Excuse me. Sorry. Yes.
Let's see, you have a telephone around your, on your belt here, and you have some tools.
Yep.
Now, you must be a telephone repairman.
Oh, you sure got my number. Get it, number? Yeah, that joke goes a long distance.
Not long enough for me.
Yeah, just sing, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, a telephone man will fix your phone when you cannot get a dial tone. If you call me, I will take a look, but please don't leave it off the hook. For a telephone man's a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
And a subway man's a person in your neighborhood.
They're the people that you meet.
When you're walking down the street, they're the people that you meet each day.
Well, I gotta be going. I'm in training.
You wouldn't be handing me a line, would you?
Oh, I love these jokes.
Oh, wisest person in the world, what's the difference between all, some, and none?
It's a snap, my son. My bowl is full of oranges. That means I have all the oranges. Your bowl is empty. You have none of the oranges, Dig.
Yes, but what about the word some?
I was getting to that. Right now, I have all the oranges, and you have none, right?
Right.
I will pour part of the oranges from my bowl into your bowl. Now, you have some of the oranges, and I have some of the oranges.
How about that?
Now, there's more. I will now pour the rest of my juicy oranges into your bowl, leaving mine empty. Now, you have all of the oranges, and I have none. You get it?
I think so, but let me run through it again.
Good.
When we started out, you had all of the oranges, and I had none.
Uh-huh.
And you gave me part of the oranges, so you have some of them, and I have some of them.
Right.
And you gave me the rest of the oranges, so now I have all of the oranges, and you have none. How was that?
You finally got it.
Yeah, and thank you for the oranges.
Boy, it took him long enough. Some people just aren't very smart.
Thank you so much for coming by to see Gordon, Dr. Ramos.
Oh, glad to. This is on my way to the hospital anyway. And tell Gordon not to worry. It's just a quick case of the flu.
Oh, good. Oh, my goodness.
Big bird. Oh, hi, Olivia.
What's the matter?
Well, the truth is, I feel sort of hot and funny all over, and my throat hurts a lot.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, you're in luck, because I have a friend of mine here with me who can take a look at you and tell you exactly what's wrong.
Really?
Yes, her name is Dr. Ramos.
Doctor.
Dr. Ramos, Big Bird.
Well, being a bird, maybe I have chicken pox.
You do have a fever, Big Bird.
Huh?
Let me see your throat.
My throat? Here it is.
There's the trouble. Your tonsils are very swollen and red.
They are? Well, what are tonsils?
Oh, they're two small things that grow way back in your mouth where your throat begins. And sometimes they can get infected and make you feel sick.
Well, what can I do to feel better?
Well, most of the time nowadays, the doctor can help a person get better by giving them medicines. But yours looks sort of bad. I say you probably ought to come to the hospital where I work and let us take them out.
You mean go to the hospital to stay a while?
Yes, but you'll see. The hospital is a bright, clean place with lots of other doctors and nurses to help you feel better.
Well, I'll be away from my friends, though.
Oh, Big Bird, you know we're going to come and see you. And besides, you'll be there with a lot of other people and you might get some new friends.
Will it hurt when you take out my tonsils?
Well, we'll put you to sleep for a while when we do, so you won't feel a thing. Of course, your throat is going to feel sore for a few days afterwards, but soon you'll be better than ever.
Well, I do want to feel good again. And if going to your hospital will help me feel better, then I'll go, but could I bring my teddy bear with me?
Of course you can. You can bring Teddy. So while you do, you talk to him, we're going to go make the arrangements.
Okay. Did you hear that, Radar? You can come to the hospital with me. Yeah, and look, the hospital's a nice, clean, bright place. You don't have to be afraid. And the doctors and nurses are real nice. And you'll feel better.
Okay? Oh, boy.
Hey, what you doing there, Bert?
Oh, boy, Ernie, I got this terrible itch here right in the place on my back that I can't scratch, you know? It's driving me bananas. Oh,
I know how you feel there, Bert. Nothing worse than having an itch where you can't reach it. Hooey! You know, just thinking about it, though, makes me itchy. I got an itch on my bicycle I can't reach, too.
Oh, yeah? Oh, boy, that's terrible. Hey, Ernie, hey, hold it. Hey, you know what? I got an idea.
What's that?
See, I got an itch that I can't reach, and you got an itch that you can't reach, so how's about we trade?
You mean you take my itch and I'll take yours?
Right. No. Look, you see, you scratch my back where it itches, and then I'll do the same for you, okay?
Oh, what a great idea, Bert. Yeah. I can reach your back, you can reach my back.
Right.
Hey, turn around, and I'll scratch your back.
Oh, that's great.
There you go. Okay, now you do mine.
Okay.
Okay, a little bit lower there, Bert. A little bit lower.
Okay.
And on over now.
Right.
Over towards the shoulder.
Right.
Okay, and now down a little bit. Down a little bit from where you were.
All right.
Oh, that feels good. Oh, that's great, Bert.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, everybody ought to do this. Matter of fact, everybody, scratch. Okay, keep going, Bert.
Okay, I'm going.
Oh, over to the left.
Oh, yeah.
Boy, that's great.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Bert, you're a very good scratcher. Did you know that?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I was just,
Me.
Wait a minute.
Tea. Sparkles in the water, or like stars.
I'm green. It'll do fine.
It's beautiful.
We are, Big Bird. How are you feeling, Big Bird? Linda wants to know.
Oh, well, much better. And the doctors gave me some medicine that makes me feel better. And the nurses are so nice, they brought me some coloring books.
Oh, that's great. Well, how do you like the hospital?
Oh, it's nice. The room is bright and cheery, and I have my own television set to watch.
Yeah.
And the food isn't bad, and I met some boys and girls, and we've become friends.
Oh, that's nice.
Big Bird, does your throat really hurt?
Well, a little.
Well, if it only hurts a little, why are you whispering?
Well, this is a hospital, and there's lots of people here who are sick, and they need their rest, so I'm whispering.
That's nice.
You know, Big Bird, that's very kind of you. We all brought you some presents while you're in the hospital, Big Bird.
Did?
Yeah, presents. Yeah, presents. Some flowers?
I love flowers.
And a baseball glove?
A baseball glove? But I love baseball gloves.
I got you a toy truck.
A fire truck, David. Right. I always want a fire truck. Look at this. It goes up and down. Oh,
and here's the latest comic book.
Oh, it's great. What else? Comic books.
Wait.
Oh, look at this submariner. Oh, wow.
Wait. Sorry.
Wow. Look at this.
This is the capital letter U. It's round on the bottom. See? And if you stand on it, like this, you can rock back and forth. But the capital letter is used mostly for names and places, like Utah, United States, United Nations. So you see, the capital letter U is used for many things. But I like to play it like a guitar.
Hello there. My friend and I here are going to show you a little bit about eating.
Hi.
Now, in a few moments, he is going to give you an actual demonstration of how to use the knife, fork, and spoon.
Now eat, huh?
No, not yet. In a few moments, I said, remember? Okay, now the first thing we're going to talk about is the knife. Okay, now see this? This is a knife.
Knife.
Now you use the knife to do things like cutting meat.
Eat.
No. I didn't say eat, I said meat.
Oh.
Okay, now you can use the knife to cut the meat. You also use the knife to spread things like butter.
Oh, butter.
Jelly.
Peanut butter.
On your bread. Okay?
Yeah.
That's the use of the knife.
Yeah, knife.
Now, the next thing is the fork.
And
here is a fork.
Yeah.
Now, you can tell it's a fork because it's got these four little pointy things on the ends of it.
Oh.
See? Now, that's what a fork is. Now, you use a fork to pick up things like meat.
Meat.
No. I didn't say eat. I said meat.
Oh.
You use a fork to pick up the meat. You use it also to pick up vegetables.
Oh, vegetables.
See? And you also use the fork to hold the meat still while you're cutting it with your knife.
Oh.
Isn't that neat?
Yeah.
See that?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, then, that is the knife and fork.
Knife and fork.
You can hold those.
Thank you.
Now, while we talk about the spoon.
Spoon.
Now, look at the spoon. And notice the spoon has this clever little bowl shape there, you see?
How clever.
And we use the spoon to scoop up things like soup and gravy.
Gravy.
And other things that don't fit very well on your fork.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, spoon.
Here is the spoon.
Thank you.
And,
Now eat.
No, wait a second. Just one more second.
No.
As we said before, we're now going to have an actual demonstration of how to use the knife, fork, and spoon for eating.
Yeah.
Now, are you sure you know how to use them?
Oh, I know how.
Okay, you may now go ahead and eat.
Okay. Knife, spoon, fork. One, two, three, go! Nom, nom. Delicious. Oh, delicious. Oh, good.
I bet you never saw a banana like that before, did you? Watch. Well, see how I do it? See, what I'm doing is I'm pretending that I'm playing the banana. But what I do is I squeeze on a horn. Watch. See? Pretty neat, huh? Hey, here comes Kermit. Let's play a trick on him. Hey, Kermit.
Hi-ho.
¿Cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás? That's Spanish for how are you?
Oh, ribbit. That's froggish for I'm fine.
Oh.
What you doing here?
Oh, I was going to play a little game here. Want to play with me?
Oh, sure. Oh, yeah. I like games. Oh, yeah.
Can you
me
tell?
Me and games, we like each other. Mm-hmm. Yes, what?
Oh, you do?
Yes, what's the game?
Can you tell which one of these things that I have here is not like the others?
Well, let's see. What do you got here, huh?
What's this over here? This is
a harmonica.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And we have
a whistle.
Whistle.
Right.
And a.
You got a horn.
Horn. Mm-hmm. Right. And a banana.
A banana.
Now, which one of these is not like the others?
The banana.
Oh, wait a minute. Come here. Wait a minute.
That's an easy game there.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
Nothing to it.
Make it harder now. Why do you say the banana?
Well, I will tell you why I said the banana. Let us review the things that we have down here, okay? Shall we?
Okay.
Why not? Okay.
This is a
harmonica down here, right. And what you do is you blow into a harmonica. You see, like that,
mm-hmm.
And it makes kind of music.
Okay.
And then you got a whistle there, and if you blow into the whistle, you see, it makes music.
Beautiful.
And then you got that horn thing there, and if you blow into the horn, you see, it makes music.
Makes music.
But the banana, which is the correct answer. You cannot blow into the banana to make music.
Well, wait a minute. How can you say that? Have you ever tried to blow into a banana?
Of course not. You can't blow into a banana and make music. Everybody knows that.
Well, I'd like to try. Watch.
I'd like to try it. Good heavens. That's fantastic.
Isn't it?
Oh, that's incredible. Oh, that's a trick.
I played a trick on you.
Yes, you sure did. Yes, you were just pretending to blow into that banana.
That's right.
And you were squeezing that horn over there, weren't you?
Right.
Oh, isn't that? What a neat trick. Oh, I'd like to play that trick on somebody else. Can we play that trick on somebody else?
Yeah, who is there?
There's Cookie Monster. Cookie Monster, come here. Come over here. Come over here. We got a game for you.
Oh, game?
Yes,
game. Frog.
Me
love games.
Hey, listen, I'll do the talking and you do the hard thing. Okay? Okay, now then. Here's the game. Nothing. Okay, here's the game. Now, we got four things down here on the table, see?
Yeah.
And you must tell us which of these things is not like the other ones.
Oh, that easy.
Okay.
Banana different.
The banana's different. Well, why do you say that?
Oh, because harmonica is to eat. And whistle is to eat. And the horn is to eat. But banana. Banana is to make beautiful music with.
Monkeys make funny noises.
In the operating room having his tonsils out, and we're just waiting for him. You must be Big Bird's new friends that he met in the hospital. Are you?
Yes.
Oh, good. I'm Bob, and this is Linda.
Mm-hmm.
Would you like to wait with us?
Yes.
Would you?
Yes.
Okay, why don't you pull up a chair? Should be back soon.
Yeah.
Oh, Linda has an idea that we can do while we're waiting. Okay, good. She's going to teach you some signs, you know, in sign language that you can use while you're in the hospital. Okay? Would you like to learn some signs from Linda?
Yeah.
Okay. This is the first one. Right. That's good, because this is the sign for H, and this is like the Red Cross band that people wear on their arms. You've seen those Red Cross bands like
that? Yeah.
So you take the H for hospital and make it a cross like that. Everybody, try that.
Sick.
Try it. Good. Take these two fingers and make a cross right over here. That's it. Good. Okay. Got another one? Oh, I bet you can guess what that one is. What does that look like?
Springs.
Springs. What'd you say? Pains?
Springs.
Spring?
Springs.
No.
Springs.
It's kind of a hard one, but if you... What do you get up in your head?
A headache,
right. So if you're sick in your head, you have a headache, and you don't feel well in your stomach, you're sick. So this is the sign for sick. Everybody do that.
Headache.
Point your head and your tummy, and that's being sick. Okay, that's not. Got another one? Good. Oh, this is a hard one. This is a very hard one. I think I'll have to tell you this one because I couldn't figure this one out either when I first heard it. But sometimes at the drugstore, they grind up medicine and pills in that little jar. It's called a mortar and pistol. And so this, they're pretending that they're grinding up the medicine in a little jar. Try it. Try it on your hand. Just take this finger and grind up those pills with that medicine. So that's the sign for medicine. Can you say that?
Medicine.
Right.
Medicine.
Good. Okay. Look carefully. This is the sign for D, and it's a word that starts with D. And you know what? Sometimes they... Do you ever have anyone put their fingers right here? Do you know what they do when they're there? Take your pulse. So you take the sign for D like this, and you put it right here. And you know what that stands for? Want to guess?
Yeah.
Who might take your pulse with a word starting with D?
Me.
You? You could.
Yeah. Huh?
A doctor? Right. That's good. See, the doctor takes your pulse. Okay, now here's another one. This is the letter for N. Now, who else might take your pulse starting with the letter N? Who?
Nurse.
Right.
Hey.
The nurse. You're going to take it again?
Yeah.
Well, you could. Maybe you know how to do it. But this is a sign for N, and a nurse takes your pulse too, so that's another one. Hey, that's very good.
I'll be a doctor.
Will you? That would be terrific. Listen, I have a sign, the best sign of all when you've been in the hospital. See if you can guess this one. It's kind of hard, but I'll give you some clues. This is the sign.
Can you be the doctor too?
Can you guess what that might be?
Kiss.
Kiss?
Yeah.
No, but that's a guy like that one. But here, I'll give you another clue. It's a place where you eat and sleep.
Sleep?
Where do you do that?
In bed.
If you're sick in the hospital, you might do it in bed. But if you're not sick, where do you usually eat and sleep?
In the house.
In a house at home, right? So this is the sign for home. It's where you eat and sleep. And that's the best sign of all after you've been in the hospital, right?
I'm not sick. I'll be the doctor. She'll be the nurse.
Would you take my pulse?
Grover. Nobody else. What? There is somebody else over there. And he looks familiar. Where have I seen him before? You know what? I think that is me. I will ask. Excuse me, sir, but I do not know how to say this. Are you not me? Yes, indeed. I do believe I am you. This is very confusing. Now there are two Grovers. One and two. Oh, boy. Hello there. Now there are three Grovers. One, two, and three. I do not believe this. Neither do I, nor I. Believe it, I am here. That is four Grovers. One, two, three, and four. All right, you guys. Now enough is enough. Now there are just too many of me. Well, that is the way you feel about it, Grover. Oh, good. You know, you can have too much of a good thing. One of me went away. And four, take away one, is three. One, two, three. That is better. Excuse me. I think I hear our mommies calling me. Bye-bye. Well, now that is even better. There are only two of me now because three take away one is two. One and two. Yes. No. No? No. I am getting tired of this. Bye-bye. Oh, thank goodness. Two take away one is one. Me. Ah, one again. And now at last, there is only lovable, furry Grover and nobody else. Bye-bye. Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!
Adios, Grover! I'm so confused.
Seven spooky spiders.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Seven nickels.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Seven pumpkin pies.
Swing as high as me. Swing up high, swing up free. Come and swing along with me. Swing up high, swing up free. Look around and see the pretty things I see. Swing up high, swing up free. Come and swing along with me. Sunshine, morning breaking overhead. Come on, lazy bones.
Was the fire bell.
Right! Gotcha!
Yes, that means the engine will be leaving any minute now. So, get your axe.
Right!
Right. Nuh-uh.
this isn't a funny shape bowl. This is the letter U. And the word uniform begins with the letter U. Do you know what a uniform is? Watch. Football uniform. Baseball uniform. Sailor uniform. Soldier uniform. Band uniform. Policeman uniform. Fireman uniform. Mailman uniform. Cook uniform. Train engineer uniform. You.
Bird, you knew we were going to come to see you. We're your friends.
Oh, hi.
How are you feeling, Big Bird?
Well, I'm feeling a little sleepy. And my throat hurts a little where they took my tonsils out.
Oh, I got good news for you. You can have ice cream. That'll make your throat feel better.
Really?
Yeah.
Ice cream?
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Lucky me.
Hello, Big Bird.
Hi, Doctor.
Hi, Doctor. Did you bring me some medicine, like maybe some ice cream?
No. The nurse will bring that soon. But I did bring you something else.
What? What?
A medal.
A medal?
For being an A number one hospital patient. And really? The only bird I know who's had his tonsils out.
Oh, gosh. I never had a medal before.
Well, you deserve it.
I know.
Now, you rest some more, and soon you'll be able to leave the hospital and go home to your nest.
Yeah? Oh, gee. Gosh, it's kind of nice here. And my friends visit me and bring me presents, and I get ice cream here. Doctor, do you think maybe you could look me over and find out something else wrong?
O-I-U-Y-T. Typewriter. T. Typewriter. T. T. Toe. Oh.
That was an incredible song.
Yep. I like that song.
I loved it.
I loved it too.
In fact, I think that's my favorite song now. When I wake up in the morning. How does it go again?
When I wake up in the morning.
Songs,
but it always coming out bad.
Always coming out bad? Oh, I can't believe that. Kind of a cowboy song here coming from Ricardo. There once was a cowboy, his name was Ricardo. He lived. Straight. There once was a cowboy, his name was Ricardo. Then there was a horse that went to the farm. Let's see if we can make that into a complete song. He had a horse that lived on a farm. A horse doesn't live on a farm.
Of course. It lived in the farm.
A horse lives in a farm. A horse has lived in apartments like all of us.
No! It's too big.
It's too big for an apartment.
Of course.
You're right, of course. What must I have been thinking?
If we put a horse in a building, then the whole house would fall apart.
You're right. I must have been crazy to say that.
And then the family don't go in the big home.
Okay, so then we won't. What if we did? What if we sang a song about a horse in an apartment?
Well,
let's see if it works. Let's see. There once was a cowboy. His name was Ricardo, and he had a horse that lived in an apartment. That's good, except it's hard to rhyme apartment. We could rhyme it with department.
Yeah. What the word? Apartment, store, apartment, house. Every through the open apartment is a house. Every time I see a little apartment, I always go in there and buy all my clothes.
California grass.
Something, Big Bird, we're very happy that you're home again. You have to get some rest, Big Bird.
Oh, thank you, but I don't need to be told to rest because I'm really sleepy.
Go to sleep now.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters T and U and by the number 7. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.